This video discusses some advanced topic regarding business intelligence dimensional modeling. They have emerged some best practice guidelines in response to what BI practitioners have learned along the way about the best way to meet the enterprise's need for information. For example, dimensional hierarchies. Many dimensions are hierarchical. Think about calendar date or geography. Data are aggregated from the most detailed level of data, aka the lowest level in the hierarchy, up to the higher level. Typically, dashboards and reports initially display aggregated data, and business people drill down to greater level of detail. Drilling up and down is moving along the hierarchies to examine the level of detail needed for the business needs. The balanced hierarchy is the simplest of the three types of hierarchies. In it, all the dimensional branches have the same number of levels, the same consistent depth. For example, a year breaks down to a quarter, breaking down to months. In this example, we have a location hierarchy, which breaks down to region, state, city, and store. Levels are skipped in the ranked hierarchies. Both ranked and unbalanced hierarchies have branches with varying depths. A typical example is a geography or sales territory dimension. In this example, one branch has the continent of North America, country of United States, state Illinois, and city Chicago, and the other one has continent Europe, country Greece, and then city Athens, because there are no states in Greece. If there is a limited number of levels and gaps in the hierarchy, then the pragmatic approach to handling aggregated data is to treat it as a balanced hierarchy. Unbalanced hierarchies occur when the dimensional branches have varying number of levels, inconsistent depths, while still having a consistent parent-child relationship. A classic example is an organizational HR chart. The structure is unbalanced, some branches in the hierarchy having more levels than others, the number of employees at each level varies, and employee titles are not uniform across a level. But there is always a parent-child relationship until the branch encounters the leaves of business analysts and programmers. An approach to handle variable depth hierarchies is to use bridge tables. A bridge table enables the relationship between the dimensions and the facts. Mind you, a bridge table adds complexity to the model and sometimes is not used due to that. The classic star schema has facts linked to dimensions without any relationship between the dimensions. However, it's very common there are several dimensions that link with other dimensions. Outtriggers is another way to deal with that, apart from bridge tables and moving from a star to a snowflake schema. The outriggers are used when a dimension is referenced within another dimension. Using outriggers eliminates the need to redundantly store and update dimensional attributes in multiple locations. An example of this would happen if the attributes such as department's name, manager and size were placed in the employee dimension rather than accessing them in the organization dimension using a foreign key.